Good afternoon, everybody. Indeed, before we start with faculty meeting, so I wanted to present the 20 days which I spent at ICICI Hubli branch as one of the program which they used to conduct for faculty. It is called Faculty Immersion Program. In that, the 20 days which I spent there, that really helped me in updating my existing knowledge. It added to my existing knowledge, definitely. Some of the processes, things, and of course, interacting with young executives that definitely has improved my horizon, how I look at the things and work and the industry and today's world. So to start with first, what I learned first in that program. Use of technology. The intensity or the use of the technology in ICICI is the highest amongst all the banks. All of you are aware also. You say anything, they have the technology to help you and support you. Stuff, whether it is depositing money or withdrawing money or transferring money or say any services, they have the technology to enable you. So no employee can say that, I don't know what you have done when you have sent request. No, absolutely not. They can't say that because technology makes sure that at what time, what second it was, sent to you and what was the reply. And if the reply doesn't happen at your level after certain time, it escalates. It goes to the next level, and it may go to the CEO level also if you don't respond to the query or the service request of any of your customers. That is the absolute system they have. So that really has changed the way we look at the things, that if even a small thing, if a student requests something to me, if I don't address it in given time, immediately that goes to him. And if he doesn't address that at his level, that will go to the next level of his. So that is what is I learned from there. And probably that has really helped me, that how accountable we have to be there in today's market if you really want to survive. So in that way, technology has really enabled me. Then systems, they have very firm systems. Nobody will tell you what to do. Your job description, your appointment letter, once you get, that is over. Rest all, your branch manager tells you that today you have to be there in the cash counter, means you are there in the cash counter. If the branch manager tells you that you have to be there in the front desk to attend the customer, you have to be there. Loan, you have to be there. In loan, what you have to do, nobody will tell you. All the systems are laid down. Your bank software tells you that what do's and don'ts, that only you have to do. Nobody will come and train you practically, except in the induction and orientation program, where they give you brief, history and organization introduction, people involved and all, that's it. Rest all the training happens on the job. Strong processes. Processes are so strong, nobody can break them and nobody can change them literally. Only in case of some of the outdated processes, if you feel you can add the new things, only there is one suggestion dashboard. In the dashboard, you have a suggestion block where you have to click and suggest. Even that goes across from your branch manager to till the national head and see. If that is good, definitely it can be implemented. So the processes are so strong, nobody tells you your promotion, your incentives, your views, your sponsorship of any visits, tours or something from the organization if you have achieved and done better, that happens automatically. Nobody updates and nobody reminds, nobody communicates, nothing. That is there, inbuilt system is there. So the processes are so strong, everything is taken care. So even the customer who visits you, at the back side of your monitor, they have inbuilt monitor and CPU. Back side of that, are you happy? SMS here. If you are not happy, SMS here. Not happy. N to this number. It is already there. The customer who is sitting next to you, the way you speak to him or her, that matters a lot. If you or she is annoyed and if you are not done, the interaction and try to solve the problem properly, immediately take an SMS and that goes to the level. Accountability is the highest because the bank manager was telling me that the person who joins newly, 2-3 days we give them basic introduction of all the departments, how they function. 4th or 5th day we put them in the cash section. In the cash section, the person has to manage the receivables as well as the received and lending. Two things he or she has to manage. In that case, 1-0, if it misses, 1,000 rupees, if you add 4-0, you have to pay 9,000 from your pocket. There they learn it in a very hard way, so that accountability is very high. And sometimes they told me that the team spirit is also there. If a newly joined person loses, instead of giving 5,000, if he gives 50,000, remaining 45,000, how he has to contribute. So in that case, they try to find, search everything. If nothing is settling and the entire team comes voluntarily, I pay 2,000, I pay 3,000, I pay 5,000 to help one of the colleagues. That really touched my heart, because a newly joined person who has not drawn one or two or three salaries may not be able to pay so much. So in that way, the team spirit is also there. We work and we argue and we know that this is my desk, that is my desk, this is my work, this is my customer. They are so possessive about that. But when it comes to the common interest, sir, they definitely share the responsibility, the liability as well as the success. So that I found in them. All young executives who are aged between, 23, 24, 25, to up to 30, and mid-level managers who are of my age, 40 or 45 or so. Then training. Training is very intense. They have very big training facility in Hyderabad, which is very nearby ISB, Kachi Bauli, which is spread across 1.5 lakh square feet, they said. Such a huge building and infrastructure they have. Earlier, their training branch was in Bandra Kurla. They have shifted it here. Entire India's training is taken care of there. So all the basics of banking and basic training in softwares and all, it is done for 10 days, 15 days. It varies depending on your designation and job profile. So training happens there. Strong professional team, very professional, very strong team. And they know their work and their hierarchy, their responsibilities very clearly. Nobody need to remind them. So that I really learned, and I'm really quite impressed by the way they behave. Any customer, whether he is depositing 1 crore rupees in your bank or he is depositing 10 rupees in your bank, treatment doesn't vary, but only the facility, what the software and the bank gives, only that varies. Technology only varies and access and level varies. But rest all the bank employees who are there on the front desk, they all help you, they all respect you, and they all welcome you in the same way they welcome even the crorepati or the rupati. All customers are customers for them. Great brand of ICICI. One thing is, they are able to sell their products, their services, their processes, and their brand. It is because of the ICICI brand, which is one of the very strongest brand, what they claim. They are so proud of their brand that when I ask them, don't you face any difficulties when you go for a sales pitch, when you visit a new customer, when you go for cold call, you don't have any appointments and all. No sir, we don't face, because when we say we have come from ICICI Bank, people look at us with some respect. So that is what we command, and it is because of definitely the brand ICICI. So that I learned. Previously, I too was of an opinion that bank means it is just, high pressure, get sales, volume, that's it, numbers. No, it is not there. It is there, of course, but you have a lot of training. I also had an opinion that if they don't perform, they remove them in between 2 months or 3 months, they fire them. No, that is also not there. The HR tries to understand, they go to the bottom and understand that why the person is really not functioning. Is there any difficulties from the brand side, from software, understanding, knowledge, training, where we are lagging, why we are not able to motivate and make that person to perform. So they study to that extent. If the person has some genuine reason, they transfer also, but they don't remove him or her. Even after that transfer, if the person doesn't perform, then the HR takes a call. But they give a chance. They don't immediately say ruthlessly, you're not there from next year or next month. They don't say that. So that is also there. So that brand definitely helps them in making the sales, and that gives them easy way, cakewalk, meeting the customer. Later, how they convert that transaction into sales, it depends on the person's ability and knowledge. How useful it was for me? It harnessed my teaching skills, definitely. We are going to use this in sales. Already me and others, we together had gone there and met the concerned person. They have told that initially they come and train these people. They will first meet them and have a meeting with these 10 people who are going to represent ICICI, then they are going to give them. So definitely it's going to help the teaching skills. What I need to train and how I need to make my students prepare for ICICI, that I learned here. So that definitely has improved my teaching skills. Interacting with young executives will help me in shaping my teaching methodology. In subsequent time, when I visit them very frequently, I did not meet everyone there, only the concerned person, whomever the list and the responsible people were there. Only for them I met there. But henceforth, whenever I go there, definitely interacting with it, all these young executives is going to help me in harnessing my teaching skills and delivering better in my classroom. I personally came to know banking operations. I was not aware that so much of things were involved. Okay, banking operations I was not so much aware, because people go deposit money and they lend money, those who have accounts, and they issue some loans and take some deposits. That was only my concept. But ICICI Bank has really opened my mind that the operations are beyond that. The services I listed in the last slide, so many services they provide, that to people who have, you know, gold account, platinum account, diamond account, these accounts, they have facilities which we can even, we cannot imagine in India. Such facilities are available, all internet facilities, whether it's fund transfer, you know, taking cash or transferring it, starting business or whatever. Technology is going to help you at every step of your operations. Then the next point is understood sales operations. Especially the sales, I thought that only the people who are working there have to find out their leads and go. It's not. The software itself suggests them that this customer from the last 5 years is our customer. His deposits are like this. At the end of the every month, the last day of the month, they call it, the amount maintained in the account is this much for the last 3 months, 6 months, 4 months. Why don't you go and pitch them for FDs? Why don't you pitch them for some insurance schemes, investment schemes? So that is how the software itself suggests all the outbound salespeople who go on the field. And these people call them, take appointment and convert that only the person who has just a savings account there, they go for multiple cross-selling and they convert them into insurance, other investments, mutual funds, and investments in the ICICI Direct. So in this way, you have all these other opportunities just with the core banking. Came to know the customer importance for banks. They say that a customer lost for the bank, it is lost for the lifetime of the bank. So customer is given prime importance. So there, all the transactions are recorded. Whenever customer comes, whatever service request is there, and people who are not able to deposit cash up to 2 lakh rupees, they can deposit directly into cash deposit machines. But if the customers are not able to do that, bank executive, despite of their busy schedule, sitting with customers, they go along with that depositor and help them. And they have trained the security person also, sometimes the security person helps them. So in that way, they take care of, you know, providing the best service possible. It is only the best experience what they give, and that fetches the next customer. And I asked him, how do you increase your account openings and all? He said, most of the time, 30% of our account openings happen through our customer service. Because existing referrals, existing people, they refer so many people because they have got the best service. That is how we maintain our relationship. And understood how important is the customer satisfaction to stay profitable in the business. There is one girl I met there, her name is Vanita. She's from Ilkal MBA College. She born and brought up in Bagalkot, pursued her MBA in Ilkal. Just imagine a girl from Ilkal, Bagalkot, studied her MBA, her graduation in Bagalkot in Ilkal only, Ilkal. Went to Bangalore, got into ICICI Bank. Today she handles all the corporate accounts of Hubli Dharwad, salary accounts, corporate accounts. And she alone goes and pitches. You name the biggies of Hubli, she knows. So, Kimji, she knows. Vikram Shuru, she knows. Vivek Pawar, she knows. You just tell her, she said, sir, I went. She has developed her relationship and her customer relationship to the extent these families call her even for their personal functions, birthdays, anniversaries and some pujas at home. So I attend that also. So that is the extent that girl, and she worked in Rajajinagar branch in Bangalore. And again, she got married and came to Hubli. And you have to see that lady, I will definitely call her to motivate our girl student that we can't do sales. And she sells corporate accounts, man, with minimum balance or the facilities or to the corporates who just open an account, and later she converts all the accounts into insurance, mutual funds and other investments. So that is what I found. She says, how about meeting your targets? Sir, meeting target is not a problem. No, only just managing my customer is more important. You have to give me good feedback. It's not only the numbers. Numbers are, of course, are there. The customers also have to give you the better rating also. if your rating is good, then definitely your promotion is definitely there in the next year. Nobody tells you that, you know, you have to do that, or you will be chasing that promotion, you will be chasing that growth, you will be chasing that enhancement. That is what I learned in this particular session. Next one is, how useful for GBS? What I learned and how I'm going to use it, that is obviously there because I have spent my 20 days, 2 hours, you know, time every morning. But now, how it is going to be helpful for GBS? First thing is, network with ICICI executives. From the date I met them in Bangalore to till the training, I contacted from the national head, the executive director to till the regional HR manager and all. So that network is going to help me, first of all, to, you know, get them for the guest lectures across all the subjects, whether it is HR, whether it is finance or marketing, sales or whatever. First, getting them in GBS is one point. They have agreed also, and we have already pitched also for that, we are going to call you. The next important thing is that even for big occasions, we may call some of the national heads. Maybe Bhumika is there or Galacto is there. For such events, we can call them because they are very good orators, have enough knowledge and this thing. If they agree, there is nothing like. So in this way, we will be able to be there in their mind. Second important thing is guest lectures across all the subjects. Then the SIP and MCP, definitely we can pitch in. MCP definitely is going to happen there. Some of the students who are interested in ICICI Bank, we start preparing them right now. So they can clear the interview as well as they can clear the things. Then semester projects, if any small project, semester projects, if you want to carry out, those people are going to be involved. Like sales project, what we discussed, those projects are also going to be there in that bank, and that's going to help us. Placements in ICICI Bank, ultimately that is also one of the objectives we are looking at. So far we have not got ICICI Bank campus placement, they have not visited us. We will definitely look at, you know, getting them here. Last one is helpful in teaching sales management for finance students. So that we have taken very seriously and we'll definitely do it. The best thing is, if these people are trained in all their products, probably they have better knowledge, their placement, their selection, you know, possibility is going to be higher than any other MBA students around here, because these people already know the bank, product and the processes. About Hubli ICICI branch, 14-year-old branch, and it is 157 branch in the country. Around 200 plus employees are there in that entire building. On an average, 2.5 crore inflow, 75 lakh outflow every day transaction. Monday to Friday and Saturday. Monday, Friday and Saturday peak days. Very high volume transaction. Sometimes one day collection runs close to 3 crores also. Then 350 walk-ins per day on an average. And two cash deposit machines up to 2 lakh in one day, they can, you can deposit. So these are the facilities which are there in the Hubli branch, and other services what they provide. I'll just move on to the next slide. The technology, Finacle is a B2B, it is developed by Infosys. This software helps the, you know, bank to transact with another bank. It is with other SBI or government banks or HDFC or other banks. This is B2B basically, bank to bank. You know, this particular software helps them in transactions with the intra-bank transactions. The next one is FCRM is B2C and C2B. Whatever the bank wants to tell the customer, SMS, updation, service, that the bank tells, updates, informs, sends SMS. And whatever customer wants to request or service, the customer will be logging into this particular software and he or she will be raising the service request. Help desk, local internal communication. Help desk is one of the software which they use internally for their communication and all. Maximum they don't use papers, as much as possible they reduce, no paperwork. I did not find any paper coming to, except those ICMS, these people who take the cash management people now, those who come with van, take all the cash, deposit in the safe. Only those people, they come with the papers, they have to approve and check number of bundles of denomination that the manager has to literally check denomination and sign. Only that I have seen in my 20 days of stay there. Rest all transactions were softwares only, internal communication, through which all the approvals through the personal ID. So no signature, no hard copy, I have hardly seen any papers used by the customers. The bank people, amongst themselves, whatever transaction they did. Next one is iView to handle privileged customers. We have high net worth individual customers. They call it HNI customers for them, and NRIs. There is subtitle software. I asked him, what is the specialty of this software from FCRM, which is B2C and C2B. They said this software reminds us their birthdays, their important days, anniversaries, festivals. All these are going to help us, through which we directly communicate and talk to the customers. So that delights them. So special services are inbuilt in this particular software for a high net worth individual who have a very big account where the transaction runs into crores per month. So for such customers, this particular software will run. Then cash sorting machine. I was only aware of cash counting machine and finding out counterfeit notes. But after going there, I found that there is cash sorting machine also, which is going to help you not only just identifying fake notes, not only just counting the cash, but also sorting. What is that sorting? I asked him what is the specialty of this machine. He told me that in 100 bundles of 1000 notes, there may be one note which is of only 100. There may be 100 note. And cash counting machine counts 100 notes only. So there is 100,000 notes. But it doesn't tell you that there is 100 note. And another thing, that is also original note. So it doesn't say that it is a fake note. So there was a problem. And sometimes people used to pick two notes and put one note. They used to fold it and insert in between. Well, counting the only the front part of the notes is going to be counted. So you used to get the correct count. So these incidents have happened to separate this. So we decided to go this. That cash sorting machine will give denomination, original, fake, outdated, any note which is not having date also, that also it sorts out. Nowadays it is mandatory, no? Before December we have to submit the notes which don't have the year of printing, that date. So I asked him that, and they also updated me that how the fake note and this thing are dealt with. Other bank, government bank, they cut it. They give half to the customer and half they keep with them. But these people, they take that fake note and take a note and deposit, keep it in bank. They take it as a fake note, register it, write all the details of that, they forward it to the chest, and from the chest, it goes to RBI. So that is the procedure they follow. They don't cut the note or they don't take it or give it back, no. They get it, record it, make a documentation of it, they write down all the details, number, all those code numbers and all, and they document it and send it to the chest is in Panji, where entire cash of ICICI Bank goes and deposited there. So there they send it, from there it is sent to RBI. Then cash authentication machine. So again the same, it authenticate that it is original or fake. It was there. He shown me that 500 note which he shown me, which was very crisp, and the genuine note, I was not able to differentiate between these two. Since I had little knowledge about fake and counterfeit notes, I tried to tell him some of the character internal security features and external security features. Based on that, I was able to trace some of the thing. He told me that finally what really matters in identifying. He just scratched that lane, security thread, and in case of fake note, it just came out. It was like a paint, it came out, but in original note, it didn't. So that was one. And second thing is touch and feel effect. Every day when you count cash, the original and fake note. So our cashiers are also there. They are also like cash sorting machines only. So immediately they are able to feel it and understand that this is a fake note. So these are some of the things which are learned there. In my lifetime, first time I saw cash of around 6.5 crore. All bundled and all the boxes were open. So much of money I saw first time in my life. So it was, I asked them details that how it goes and what is the security. They told that even the jeep in which they carry the amount, which is having GPS system connected, wherever that vehicle moves, it is shown in the tracker. One thing, it is bulletproof, it is bombproof, and two guards with guns, and that vehicle is not supposed to stop anywhere more than 5 minutes. If it stops more than 5 minutes, immediately they receive call, and nearby police station also receives the call that our so-and-so vehicle number stuck in this particular place, so kindly help us. Immediately police rushes there, everything. So that is what is the system. They are not supposed to have food, that, this, only in case of emergency they have to stop the vehicle, otherwise no. When they start from here, they have to reach final destination. In between the no stoppage. So that is what is the system they follow. And there are two keys. One key these people maintain. They lock the trunks, put the seal, signature. Another key is with the chest there only. These people don't have another key. Plus the security tab. Even that to base some number code that is entered, and all your amount is insured again. So any amount which goes out of the bank, anything goes wrong, bank is not responsible. Once they have submitted the, handed over the cash, physically as well as officially, once they send the report and click submit, their responsibility is over. Though the cash is in the bank itself, if it is robbed, ICICI is not responsible. So that they have insured, even that agency also has insured, their employees are also insured. So that is how they manage the entire cash. So services available, loans available, all sorts of loans, personal, home, or you know, vehicle loan or whatever it is. Deposits, they have various types of deposit schemes they have. Insurance, Lombard and Prudential, both they have. Core services like banking services, DD, opening account, transfer and all they have. Account openings, ICICI Direct also they have, they same building. Forex services also they provide, but it is not so high, it is there. I asked him what is the volume, sir, it is not much. Maybe in a day we may get $1,000 or maybe maximum $5,000. If some companies have huge imports or huge exports, at that time they come buy or they come here to receive the cash. Only in that case, sometimes our transactions run into up to $40,000-$50,000. Other than we don't have. And he told me that in Goa, per day transaction is 3 crore it seems. Per day forex transaction, 3 crore per day, only forex. Right? Because of the tourist place and all these things. Then forex is there, lockers are there. Even the lockers have been automatized. They have shown us one video, I think sir also watched it. So everything is automatic. You have to just go and in the kiosk, they have to just press in the building, one kiosk. You have to enter your code name. You need not to go to the locker itself comes to you through that kiosk machine, it opens. Once you take all your stuff and again you submit it back, again it goes back. So that is how they have automatized everything. They are going to be launching it very soon across the country. Then credit cards and the payment gateway. This is what the various services they have which for us. Thank you for the patient hearing. Thank you sir for permitting and sending. And 2 hours which GBS gave me every day. Definitely we will give it back, definitely with the team. I definitely will give it back to the student and to the college. Are there any queries, any questions?
So, frankly speaking, not a question of thanks, it's more of your effort regarding your. But this experience and what I have seen myself, I think will give a lot of learning for us.